So my name is Nicholas Crouch, and I was in the U.S. Navy for 6 years where I was in IT. And I'll tell you what, man, I had an amazing career going. Picked up rank really fast, did 3 different deployments. And during my third deployment, which was in 2011, I was on the ship working out and doing a little too much. And I ended up throwing my back out. And when I say throw my back out, I mean it went bad. So, and that pretty much put my career, you know, came to a screeching halt. And after about another 3 to 4 years trying to, you know, get treatment on my back, you know, doctors, it was a grim outlook. And they kept telling me the same thing, you know, that there's nothing they can do. There's nothing that anybody could do, and my back's only gonna get worse. And eventually I ended up getting medically retired, 100% disability from the military. And I was, at that point, I got medically retired at 27 years old. So still young, I still had my whole life in front of me. I was injured for 6 years, you know, for the last 6 years. And during those 6 years, you know, I went through the med board, went through all these changes, and I bounced around between multiple different pain management doctors, multiple different spinal surgeons. I've had a total of 8 rounds of injections in my spine, where every one of those rounds was a minimum of 3 injections. They never helped. They never did anything. And I was told every time by military doctors and civilian doctors that, you know, it's only gonna get worse, and there's really nothing we can do for you. My pain management doctor finally said, you know, we're done with the injections, we're done, that he couldn't do anything else for me. And so he referred me to the Fondren Clinic in Houston, which is supposed to be one of the best spinal surgeons or spinal clinics in America. And I got a call probably 2 or 3 weeks later from Fondren Clinic saying that none of their doctors would see me because of how bad my back was, that they refused to see me because they wouldn't operate. So they referred me to another doctor who was basically one of the best spinal surgeons in America, if not the world. And I started going to him. He wanted to do a few more injections in my spine just to see if, you know, his techniques would work and could give me some relief. Same results. I got no relief at all. So finally, he told me, we sat down and started talking about surgery. And he told me that out of my spine, that he could only operate on about 50% of my back. And then out of that, he could possibly be able to fix 50% of that. So literally, you know, 25% of my back he could possibly fix. And I was at the point where, you know, I didn't care. Even 25%, you know, if that was better than nothing. Life was tough. I mean, I couldn't do things as simple as reading a book to my son at the end of the day, you know, at bedtime, because all I wanted to do was basically just go down and lay down and go to sleep. Because, I mean, the pain was just so intense. I couldn't even pick my daughter up and hold her for more than, you know, maybe half a minute or so. I mean, it was just a miserable way of life. And after going to other doctors, going to pain management doctors, going to spinal surgeons, you know, trying tons of different treatments, a lot of, you know, total of 8 different injections in my spine, nothing worked. Nothing, it was still the same outlook. There was no hope.
It was one of those things where he was so sick, he would go lay down. He was like, oh, I've got, my back hurts. I need to go lay down. I'm sorry, I can't go to this birthday party with you. I need to go, my back is hurting. We can't go to the carnival, I'm sorry. We can't do this. And it was getting to where we were having to hire yard people because he couldn't mow the yard. And I was so busy with the kids, and because he was hurting, that he couldn't take care of the kids. And it was kind of dark for a little while there, because we were starting to fight because I was doing everything and I was taking care of everything. I felt like almost like a single mom at sometimes, because he was always hurting. Ever since he started coming to see Dr. Daigle, he goes to birthday parties with us. He mows the yard now. He wants to barbecue. He wants to go out and do things with his friends. And we're spending more time together, and it's so much better. I can see him going outside and he's playing with the kids now, and he's playing baseball, and he's getting involved and helping with taekwondo and dance, and it's a totally different person than what he was. So I feel like I have my husband back. I feel like my kids have their dad back. I feel like we have our marriage back and our family back, and it's great. My kids go in to wake him up in the morning and I can hear him laughing and giggling, and it used to be they'd come back, Dad's back's hurting. Dad's hurting, Dad doesn't want to get up right now. But now it's giggles and laughs, and we get up and we go to the park and we go to the beach, and we used to not do any of that. So my marriage is back, my family's back, my everything is how it was before he got injured.
I mean, I went from barely being able to walk, barely being able to do much of anything, to being able to play with my kids, pick my kids up and throw them around, being able to read the book to my son at bedtime without being just in excruciating pain or wanting to do nothing more than just go lay down. I was able to do all that kind of stuff. It was amazing, and that was just in 2 months. Within that next month, I'm probably 100% better, and it's continued. I haven't regressed any, and they literally gave me my life back. So if you're sitting here and, you know, my story is resonating with you, give them a shot. Give this a chance. You have hope. You can get better, and you will get better if you give them an opportunity.